Hi everyone, this is the another example on orthogonal trajectories. Find the orthogonal trajectories of semi-cubical parabolas ay square is equal to x cube, where a is the parameter. It means that by giving different values for a, you will get various semi-cubical parabolas in that family. Okay, given equation of the family of curves is ay square is equal to x cube. Clearly we are observing that here given family is in Cartesian coordinates. So first of all, we have to find out the differential equation of given family 1 by eliminating the parameter a. Okay, for that purpose, take derivative with respect to x on both sides. In this case, don't apply log on both sides. So whenever polar coordinates are involved, polar coordinates means given equation should be in terms of r comma theta. Before taking the derivative, you should apply log on both sides. But in the case of Cartesian family, don't apply log. Okay, so a is the constant term, differentiation of y square with respect to x is 2y. That's why I will write 2ay into dy by dx. Otherwise, you can also use the notation y dash as you wish. And in the right hand side, we have the derivative x cube, which is 3x square. From this, obtain the value of a. What is the a value? A is equal to 3x square whole by 2 times of y dy by dx. Dy by dx. Substitute this value in the given family 1. So you will get, what is a here? 3x square whole by 2y into dy by dx is equal to, in the right hand side of the given equation we have x cube. Simplify the terms. So from this, already here we have y square, don't forget this y square here. Just I am writing the a value, and here we have y square. So 1y gets cancelled, so x square gets cancelled. So remaining term is 3y is the numerator whole by 2 into dy by dx is equal to, x is the remaining term in the right side. So take this dy by dx to, just I am taking this dy by dx to this side, and take this x to denominator. So you will get dy by dx value is 3y by 2x. Take it equation number 1. Clearly this equation does not contains any parameter, and we are obtaining this one by taking the derivative with respect to x. That's why this is called differential equation of given family 1. For orthogonal trajectories, for orthogonality, we should replace dy by dx by minus dx by dy in the differential equation of given family. Okay, because dy by dx represents slope of the given family, and we are fixing the slope of required curve as minus dx by dy. If the product of these both slopes is minus 1, automatically both curves becomes perpendicular. That's why. Okay, so you will get minus dx by dy is equal to 3y by 2x. The above equation number 2 becomes 2 in this way. So separate the variables on both sides. It means that all terms of x to dx side, and take all terms of y to dy side. So you will get minus, you should send this negative sign to right side. So you will get 2x dx is equal to minus 3y dy. It is better. So take integration on both sides. Everybody knows that integration of x square is x square by 2, so 2 gets cancelled, minus 3y square by 2 plus c. After completion of integration, we should add the parameter. So x square plus 3y square by 2 is equal to c. This is the required family of orthogonal trajectories, which represents family of ellipses. Okay, this is the required family of orthogonal trajectories of given family 1. In this way, we can solve the problem. In the next video, I will give some more examples on orthogonal trajectories. Thank you very much.